3000. Keep your call coming in. That's the number you need. 0207224 2000. We're discussing identity tonight. How do you define yourself? Because Dan has been kind of technical. 0778620949. Now, joining us also tonight is Bryce Royer, who is a third culture kid. He's part French, Vietnamese, and he's part Ethiopian. He's lived on three continents and in seven countries before the age of 18, so he knows all about the needs to belong. He eats French food for breakfast and Ethiopian food for lunch. Bryce set up the website TT Kid, Third Culture Kid, to help those struggling with their identity and offer a place of belonging. He joins us on the line now from Canada. Hello, Bryce. Thanks so much for joining us.
Hi,
Jim. Just explain to us then, in terms of identity, which we've already been discussing tonight, you've got French, Vietnamese, and Ethiopian. How do you define yourself?
Well, I think the label that you talked earlier would be really interesting, because that's a really hot topic in the TCK community. And most third culture kids, they really dislike labels. They really don't want to be pigeonholed by really what they find to be superficial racial characteristics. And in their point of view, they see that why should people have to choose one part of their heritage over another? And unless Europeans speak Arabic, Asians ask questions in French. And how I define myself is, I love what Susan said, and I think, but really what I say is I'm a multiracial kid and I belong to a cross-cultural group.
You're a multiracial kid and you belong to a cross-cultural group. You should see the faces of my deck in the studio. They're just grimacing. Is this just sort of a kind of Canadian thing? Or do you think that that's the best way to define yourself?
Well, I don't say that to people.
How
I define myself.
Right.
There's no way I'm going to say that to people. People will just raise their eyebrows and say, what?
Okay. But I mean, the wider point, and that this is part of the reason why you set up this website, is to actually discuss these whole issues, giving people a forum whereby they can discuss this notion of identity.
Because what's interesting is that we have a cross-cultural identity that we're just beginning to explore as a community. And it's a big identity that holds all kinds of cross-cultural experiences. Third culture kids are really a growing prototype of a new identity that's difficult to define.
You said that you obviously have your own definition of self. What do you say to people when they ask you who you are or where you're from?
I just am from Ottawa, Canada. I'll just make it simple, you know. I don't want to complicate their lives. I just say I'm from Ottawa, Canada. It really depends on the situation, really.
And what do you mean to
most people, the box, I just say other.
Oh, you say other as well. Do you know what? I'm just going to start doing that other thing, because I just kind of fancy doing other now. But do you lean towards one culture or the other, right?
Not really. Not at all. I just feel it's difficult to choose one culture or another, because if you choose one culture, you're kind of denying the other culture, and it's difficult to do that. It's not... What TCK really hate is picking one side over the other, so we can't really choose.
And I'm just curious to know...
We have no ownership of any.
Right, and I'm curious to know what they say on the website then. Is it a continual struggle for other TCK, or are they actually quite happy to say, right, I'm just an other, and I'm happy with that?
They're unhappy if they're among people who don't actually acknowledge their experience were different. Because, I mean, one of the challenges that TCK have is belonging. I mean, I know a multiracial, half Filipino, half English third culture kid who grew up in Saudi Arabia and moved to England, and she was made fun of because she had no idea who the Spice Girls were.
Right.
And, yeah, I mean, they missed out on pop culture trends and, you know, things like that, which makes it hard to relate to their peers. But when they find a sense of belonging, when they talk to other third culture kids who grew up with the same experiences, they begin to really explore their gifts, and that's really incredible. Just having the sense of belonging and talking to other people just like you.
I'm curious to know, my guest in the studio with us, as to whether you would define yourself as a third culture kid. Would that be a label you would like?
I was going to say, speaking as a TCK,
I'm quite surprised, he said that there was a lot of CCK hate labels, but he just came out with a bunch of labels.
Being a human being, you know, identity is very important to everybody, and identity shifts. You know, your nationality shifts, you know, it's a shifting thing, and I think it's disingenuous to say that you don't, that you don't talk about maybe, you know, where you sit in terms of culture or what colour you are, because we all do, and I think that one thing that, Bryce just said is that, you know, that you don't have to choose, that you know, you're talking about choosing one culture or the other. Well, most definitely not, and there are two things here. There's something about culture, and like I began by saying that I was Irish and African and feel both of those things very, very much. And I also feel black as well, and, you know, and I feel black, it's the political. I feel black, it's literal, it's where I brought up in Notting Hill, it's what I brought up with, and the music, and the people, and the education. So I think that you lose one set of labels, as John said, or one set of things, and, you know, only to bring out another, even if it's just to say, I'm just a human being, I'm just a person, I'm just a mother.
Yeah.
They are still identities.
Well, right, perhaps you'd like to respond to this notion of, well, on the one hand, yes, let's junk the labels, but we've come up with a new label, which is CCK.
I think everybody has their right to label themselves as whatever they want. And so what I think is really amazing is when you're talking to third culture kids, I mean, in our forums, we can really relate to other cultures. I mean, we have an American-born girl who grew up in China, a Vietnamese who grew up in Switzerland, a half-Indian and Vietnamese girl born in Mongolia, and I think she grew up in South Africa. And you just talk about relationships, family, work, school, everyday things, and we seem to relate to different people from different cultures. And we don't really see ourselves with race or culture. We don't really define ourselves with identity or race.
But I mean, I suppose we all, I mean, I go back to the point that Emma was actually making, that this, but we have, there is an innate need in all of us, isn't there, about belonging, about saying, I belong here. So are you trying to create somewhere, this online forum, this website, which, by the way, is quite funny, there are pictures of that made me howl with laughter, right, I have to say. Are you trying to create a sense of belonging with that?
Well, a sense of belonging really happens when you're with people who are just like you. And when Lisa Meekin wrote the book of Third Culture Kids, and when I first read that book, it was just amazing. For the first time, I realized there were people just like me, and who had the similar experiences, and who were struggling with identity and belonging, who felt restless. And for me, that was a huge deal, because now I had a language to really speak about my experience. Well, before, I didn't really have a language. I was confused about my identity, and I felt isolated, and I couldn't make friends because I felt I had to move very soon, so I didn't want to be attached to anyone, and that's one of the issues that third culture kids have, because they move very often. And so there's all kinds of things, and it's really just amazing to be able to talk to other third culture kids.
I understand that you have actually lived in London, is that correct, or am I...
About a year,
as an adult.
Okay,
so I'm just curious, would you experience the same here in the UK that it has been in Canada?
Well, that's kind of a complicated question, because I was a different person in Canada and I was a different person in London, but I can say that when I was in England, I had difficulty belonging. Just by being third culture, if I could maybe
Is it a personal issue? Sorry, Bryce, I mean it's tongue in cheek, but is it more about a personal issue for you rather than an issue of your ancestry?
Oh no, it's not an issue about my ancestry at all. No. But I know that for many third culture kids to move very often, it's very common for them not to be able to really fully integrate into the culture because they don't really relate there. And I can speak from my personal experience, living in England. I saw a lot of fragmentation and different races and groups together, and I was wondering, you know, where is my group? And where do I belong? And I didn't find that. So But that's my personal experience, and I know that everybody's experience is different.
Well, Bryce, I have to tell you that your website was part of the reason why we're having the debate tonight, so I'm very glad that we managed to speak to you, so I do appreciate you taking the time to be with us. TCKids.com is the website. I've been speaking to Bryce Royer, who is the founder of TCKids. Thanks very much, Bryce, for joining us. I'm going to come back to the question.